My name is Srikanth Divi. I'm an assistant professor in orthopedic surgery and neurological surgery here at Northwestern Medicine. I specialize in spine surgery, degenerative conditions, metastatic tumors, adult scoliosis, and deformity correction. When Mr. Mandelman first presented to my clinic, he was stooped forward, unable to walk upright. He presented with severe low back and bilateral thigh and leg pain radiating down his thighs and calves. It was significantly affecting his ability to walk and do daily activities. Isthmic spondylolisthesis refers to abnormal motion of one vertebrae on top of another. And typically when this happens in an isthmic spondylolisthesis setting, there's a deficiency of the bone called the pars interarticularis. And that piece of bone is critical for stability between those two vertebrae. And as the abnormal motion worsens with time, you can get worsening back pain and nerve compression, especially exiting nerve root compression. Mr. Mandelman's isthmic spondylolisthesis was grade 3 on upright x-rays. This refers to the Meyerding classification, which measures the amount of translation of the superior vertebrae on the inferior vertebrae. So with Mr. Mandelman, with the grade 3 spondylolisthesis, he was about 50 to 75% translated. This x-ray shows Mr. Mandelman's standing lateral lumbar spine films. As you can see at L5-S1, there's a severe slip, which measures about a grade 3 on our classification system. What's implied here, we can't see the MRI, but there's severe bilateral foraminal stenosis of the L5 nerves on both sides. And there's also dysplastic pedicles at L5. I went over many different surgical options, including an all posterior approach or a combined anterior posterior approach. Certainly for stabilizing his L5-S1 high-grade spondylolisthesis, we discussed an in situ fusion with a decompression of his nerve roots. However, he also had a component of sagittal imbalance. And in order to correct that, we had to also address a couple of other levels in his lumbar spine. So I did an L3-4 and L4-5 anterior lumbar interbody fusion along with the L5-S1 reverse Bohlman technique, followed by posterior L3 to pelvis decompression fusion. So this is a sagittal cut of the patient's preoperative CT scan. As you can see again, there's a high-grade instability noted at L5-S1 with a large anterior osteophyte, which signifies his body trying to stabilize that segment. This is an intraoperative fluoroscopy shot showing us doing the reverse Bohlman technique. This is where I placed a K-wire in the middle of the L5 body going all the way to the posterior aspect of the S1 body. This is to guide the intraoperative placement of the fibular strut allograft. The reverse Bohlman technique is a unique way of stabilizing a high-grade spondylolisthesis. So this means anything from like a grade 3 or above, where reducing or putting the vertebrae back in place may not be as desirable for many different reasons, but one of the reasons including nerve palsy. This technique stabilizes those two vertebrae by placing another piece of allograft bone in between the two vertebrae. This is a lateral fluoroscopy shot of me putting in the fibular strut allograft as highlighted by that black arrow. So after the K-wire was placed, an ACL reamer was actually used to ream over this to create a cylindrical defect of the appropriate size. Then a fibular strut allograft was then machined to fit perfectly in this hole. And this is a shot showing the insertion of that allograft. And this shows the postoperative AP and lateral films following our reverse Bohlman procedure, followed by the L3-4 and L4-5 ALIF cages and posterior decompression fusion from L3 to pelvis. The one thing to note here is that intraoperative navigation was used for placement of the screws. This was mainly to help guide the transsacral screws, as you can see at L5, which go from the S1 body into the L5 body, which is a unique technique for treating spondylolisthesis. Patient did really well in the hospital. He had immediate relief of his nerve pain the following day. By the 2-week and 6-week postoperative appointments after he went to acute rehab, he noted significant improvement in his back pain as well as improvement in his upright posture. Northwestern Medicine is the best place to treat complex cases such as these because we have experts in every field, whether that's the exposure teams or the anesthesia teams or the clinical and intraoperative nursing teams. We also have a dedicated spine center, which evaluates patients from a complete non-operative perspective all the way to, you know, a full operative perspective. And it is a dedicated space for comprehensive care for the spine that can address anything from metastatic disease to spinal deformities to degenerative disease.